Good evening, guys. So can you hear me? All right. So can you see this quality manager screen? Okay. So can you see now this quality manager screen? Okay. All right. So basically coming to just let's quickly recap what we did in the last class. So basically we did the introduction. What is the IBM suite of tools, right? There we basically like we talked about some of the basic concepts like QA, and also we talked what are the different tools from IBM. We discussed ResNet Quality Manager, Requisite Pro, ClearQuest, Robot, Functional Tester, Soda, and those different tools, right? So we looked at what each tool is mainly meant for. Like Requisite Pro is mainly to gather the requirements, and ResNet Quality Manager is similar to your Quality Center from HP. It's a test process management tool. And coming to this automation tools, basically like similar to EFT or QTP, here we have ResNet Robot or the Functional Tester. And then we have different other tools like the Soda is basically to create the templates. And also we talked true coverage, the basically to know that code coverage whenever you run the test or any test cases. So those are the things that will be part of this introduction we discussed as a general QA concepts and also the ResNet suite of tools at high level, what are the different tools available from IBM. And today it's mostly focused on how we are going to work with this quality manager. Okay. So as we discussed, this quality manager is mainly a process management tool from IBM. Okay, so it's a process management tool. Okay, so IBM Quality Manager. save test process management tool. And it's a web-based tool. That means you're going to access this tool via a URL. You will be provided the URL and the username and passwords, like similar to your quality center. So this way, like, you can compare this tool with the quality center. Quality center from HP. So you're going to access, you will be provided in the real-time project, the application URL, the tool URL, right? And then you're going to open your browser and enter the URL, and you will be provided the username and password to log into this tool. And basically this tool gets installed on a server. Okay, so in real time, you're not going to install this quality manager on the individual systems, like same as the quality center. Whether it's a quality center or a quality manager, the tool gets installed on a server. Once that is installed on your server, you will be provided the URL to access the tool installed on the server. So in real time, you do not bother much about the installation part. Mostly that will be taken care by a senior person like administrators. So he's going to take control of installation part. So that's where, whenever just you open, so you'll be provided this URL. Open your browser, whether it's a Firefox, Internet Explorer, or Chrome, and then you're going to provide that URL, and it's going to ask the username and password, so that you're going to enter that username and password when you log in. So this is the kind of the URL that will be provided. So initially, when you are trying with this, when you are providing, when you install on your local systems for this training purpose, so this is the kind of URL you're going to enter, and then it's going to ask the username and password. So you're going to enter the username and password in order to log in. So this is the login screen. Okay, and by default, so you're going to use admin. This is the username, and password is also admin. Okay. So admin and admin, these are the username and password. You can log in into this quality manager for you to do the practice. So in real time, see, you are saying this local host, this is where you will be provided here basically the server name. Alright, because I mentioned like this is going to install on your server, here you will get the server name from which server you are accessing this particular tool. See, local host is nothing but your computer, because right now this quality manager tool is installed on your system that is a local host. That's where you're accessing the tool using this local host URL. Whereas in the real-time project, this tool gets installed on a server. Server is nothing but a common machine where all team members have access. Right? That is where this tool gets installed, and instead of local host, because it's not your system, right? So here, going to replace this localhost with the server name. Okay, so that's how actually it works in the real-time project. And the moment you join a project, you will be given the username and password to log in into the quality manager. So that's the username you're going to enter. So you're going to provide that username and password here. So when you log in, so you can enter here admin and admin, the username and password, so that it takes you to login screen. But here actually I disable that, so I'm going to log in with a different username. So once you provide the even the admin and admin, initially you should be able to log in into Quality Center. So, but I created a different user. Okay, so once the login is successful, so this is what you see, the quality manager and different other modules. Okay, so that's what like we're talking about test process management tool. What is that process you are going to manage? We know like what are the testing process, right? So what is the testing process? And the people like who are who are installed successfully, and then if you see this login window, then you can use this username and passwords to log in into Quality Manager. The people who couldn't succeed are you installed, but you're not able to open this Quality Manager, then probably I'm going to explain those things during the break. Okay, once I explain the things on the Quality Manager, so we will take maybe 10 minutes or so break, because this is a 2-hour session. And then I will explain the steps how you can open this Quality Manager on your system. Okay, first listen to the class, and then we will take those issues during the break. All right, so here we're talking about the testing process. So first step is you're going to gather the requirements. Gather requirements. Then what is the next step in the testing process? What's the next step? Test planning. Good. Then next step. Planning. Test cases, no coding. Here we are talking about the test, but no coding. Guys, no coding, no design. We are talking about the testing process. Don't confuse. When the interviewer asks, don't say the coding, design, and this thing. Then the interviewer is really confused. How come you are going to do the design and coding phases? So the next step is going to write the test cases. And the test data. Execute test case. Then report issues. So at high level, these are the different modules. So you're going to automate this process using the Quality Manager. You're going to automate this process using the Quality Manager. So how? So that's why if you look at, there are different modules here. requirements module. This is where you gather all project requirements. So here, requirements module is the one. Where we collect or gather requirements, and the next step is test plan module. So this is where we prepare project test plan. So this is the module you actually don't see in Quality Center. Quality Center you don't have this planning module. Okay, so this is the planning. And next step is the construction module. So this is where we are going to prepare the test cases. So we prepare all our test cases and test data. And like anyway, the lab management and the builds, probably I'm going to talk later, but let us focus on from the testing perspective. The tester is going to interact mostly with these requirements, planning, construction, and the execution, the next module. So lab management is mostly from the management perspective. Builds are from the developer perspective, okay? So next thing is the execution module. That's where you're going to run the test cases. Execute test case. And the next one is the defects. So reports is also sometimes the tester might work, but mostly it is again the manager of the test lead. They're going to prepare different kinds of reports using this reports module. The next one, the tester is going to interact with the defects. Okay, so that's the next one. How you're going to report issues is using the defects module. So this way, these are the main modules the tester is going to work on quality manager. So in order to manage this testing process. Okay? And then what are the advantages with the quality manager? What are the advantages with quality manager? What are the advantages with quality center? What is advantage with Quality Center? Okay, forget about integration with QTP, but what are the main things? So centralized repository, okay? The same thing here you see in Quality Manager also, you have this centralized repository of information. Centralized repository of information. That means you're going to create requirements. You're going to create test cases. And also you're going to create defects. These are basically called the test artifacts. Test artifacts are stored in the database. Basically, the quality manager is also going to use the database. So everything gets stored. These are basically the test artifacts. Requirement, test case, and defects. Everything gets stored into the database. Then what is the next advantage? It's more secured. The data is more secured. How it is more secured? How the data is more secured? So why the Excel sheet is not secured? Why the quality manager is more secured? So username and password required to log in. Good. Okay. So basically only authorized people can access the progress information. Whoever is having valid username and password, they can access the project. And also, you can more transparency among the team members. What is this transparency? Basically, what are the things we do on this quality manager? Everything is visible to the rest of the team members, right? So what are the test cases we done? What are the test cases that we executed? What are the test cases that are passed? So everybody has that visibility. It's more transparent, right? And then the next thing is you can better manage the project. How you can better manage the project? So you always link requirements with test cases. You also link test cases with defects. You can also link the defects with requirements. So what are the advantages you really get while linking these test artifacts? So here basically like you look, in the project you will get this kind of questions, right? Hey, how many requirements are tested? Or how many test cases are done against each requirement? So for example, you look at a typical project like say T-Mobile. So you have maybe 9 requirements. Then the project manager is having a question. All these 9 requirements are tested. Are we done with test cases for all these 9 requirements? Or how many defects are filed against each requirement? How many test cases passed? How many test cases failed? So these are the kind of questions the manager is having in his mind, right? Basically, he wants to see the project of the progress, how we are progressing. So in order to address these questions, you should have a link between the requirement, test case, and defect. Then you will get any kind of answer for these questions, right? That's how you can better manage your project. And also the quality manager is going to give a good reporting. Can generate good reports at the product level, the good product level reports. Okay, so these are the advantages like what you get with this quality manager tools. Like more or less it's the same like with Quality Center, the advantage. Okay, so this is basically like the theory part of it before we jump onto the tool. Anybody having any questions? Okay. So this is National Quality Manager 2, version 2. So is there any specific advantage for QM or QC? The advantage is like you will get maybe the other additional modules you get with Quality Manager. Okay, cost-wise, I don't know. Please contact IBM. So they will let you know what's the quoted today's price. Okay, so any other questions? So the advantage like with Quality Manager or Quality Center is you don't have this planning module. That's where you're going to prepare. You're going to prepare the project level test plan. So you don't have this kind of module in Quality Center. And also this lab management and the bills. So there are some modules you get in Quality Manager. So other than that, pretty much like what you see from the tester perspective, so you don't see much difference between the Quality Manager and Quality Center. Because other than this, because the planning module mostly it will be used by the product manager, that's where he is going to prepare the product test plan. Okay? Okay. Other than that, like you don't see much difference between the QC and Quality Manager. So basically like Kalaivani or whoever it is, so you already got the installation instructions. Okay. Okay, whoever is didn't attend the last Wednesday class, you please come back to the next session. No. RQM is not for mainframe testing. It is a tool for any kind of testing. Okay, it is basically a tool, not related to any mainframe or SAP or T-Mobile application or banking application. You can use this tool for any application. Okay. So don't compare with other tools, like what is the National Lab Manager, this thing, that thing. First, let us focus on this Quality Manager. Anything related to the Quality Manager, please focus on just the Quality Manager in these classes. If you really want to see the differences, what are the other tools, probably you can go to their site and then they will explain what are the other tools from IBM. Okay, so here basically like the installation part is already done in Wednesday after that. So here I'm not going to spend time on again the installation part. Okay, so let's focus on the technical things, how you are going to work with this tool. Okay, all right guys, let's continue with these different modules. Anything related to the installation, whoever missed that class, the Wednesday, so please come back to the next session. And whoever is having these installation issues, so if you didn't install, please contact tech support, techsupport@htkinfosys.com. And whoever is already installed, you're not able to open this quality manager, I'm going to look at it in the break. Okay, so now let's start with how you're going to get the requirements in quality manager. So you're going to click on this requirements module, and here you will get different menu, like either you can create requirements or you can also import requirements. This is to view existing requirement. Okay. So you can also import, okay. So let's talk about first importing the requirements, right? From where you're going to import the requirements. So we talked about there is one more tool called Requisite Pro. Right, that is also from IBM, Requisite Pro. Sometimes what happens is the business analyst is going to use that tool, Requisite Pro, and he's going to gather all requirements using Requisite Pro. That means he's going to create all the requirements in Requisite Pro. Then, because you already created those requirements, then you can directly import those requirements from the tool. That's where they import requirements. This is the functionality you can use, and it's going to say, basically this is import from external requirement system like Requisite Pro. So you select this, and then you can directly import the requirements from the tool. Because the business is already created, you do not again create the requirements here. You can directly import them. That's a very simple job. Okay? So you can import the requirements using Requisite Pro. Or, okay, you don't have any requirements created by the business analyst, then you're going to end up with creating the requirements. Okay? So this is where you're going to create the requirement. And basically it's going to give you the template. Right, and you're going to provide the summary, what the requirement is. Say, let's create a couple of requirements. So I'm going to say it's a login requirement, right? And then so going to say for 001, whatever that functionality. I'll say login requirement. Okay, and these are the default fields anyway. This is the type is the requirement. And one by here you're going to select who created this particular requirement. Right, you can select the name. So these are the different people, right? So you can select, okay, this is the person created this requirement. And most, like this kind of severity and the priority of the requirements comes from the business analyst. He's going to escalate the priority and severity of the requirements, right? That's his responsibility. So accordingly, you're going to put what's the priority of the requirement and the severity. It is a critical requirement in the project. Depends on the priority and severity, right? So we're going to develop and test those requirements earlier in the project. So if the requirement priority is high, obviously we have to develop and test those requirements in the early stages of the project. If the requirement priority is low, that can be done later part of the project or later stages of the project, right? So mainly the business analyst is going to look at what is the severity and priority levels of the project. Severity is, okay, if you don't have this kind of requirement in the project, what is that impact? That means if you don't complete this requirement, what is that impact on the application? Priority is how soon this particular requirement has to be developed. Risk is, okay, you decided we are not going to do this particular requirement in a project. What is the risk involved? Is it safe to ignore this requirement. Okay, so that's where all these fields can be decided by the business analyst. So what's that risk assessment? Is it a low risk or a high risk? If it is a high risk, that means this particular requirement must be done. If it is a low risk, okay, there is a chance that you can, if you don't have enough time to work on this requirement in the project, you can skip because the risk is low. Okay, that way it's going to come up with the risk assessment, the severity and priority of levels of the requirements, and also we're going to put some tags. So why these tags are important is, suppose one later part of the project you want to stitch, right? Hey, I'm looking for a logging requirement. So you can always search with the tag, which are nothing but the keywords. You see here, there is a search functionality. So if you put here login, then it's going to bring this requirement. Okay, all your type is here, the login, and then search. So then it's, once you put these tags, whenever you create the requirements, right, it's going to bring all those requirements related to the login functionality. Okay, and then here you're going to provide the description of the requirements. So I'm going to say on home page or the login page. So usually spell out to login to their account with a valid phone number and password. So if user provides more than or less than invalid number, I'll say more than or less than, say something 10 digits number, then the application should display an error message. Something, please enter correct phone number. Okay. And also if user forgot to enter the password, then it should display an error message saying that please enter password. So this way, he's going, like whatever that requirement that is coming from the business analyst, most of the time you do just copy paste, right? Basically, like this one, like most of the time you'll get a requirement, right? So this is the kind of requirements documents you get. So you are gathering all these requirements into the quality center, quality manager. This is the kind of requirements. So you are going to just copy and then
just Control P and then you can print.
Okay, so this is how you are going to gather requirements in quality manager. So clear? Any questions? So once you clear click on this save button, then it's going to create the requirements. And then back, tag is related to the login. Let me copy paste. Okay, so that way it's going to create the requirements. And then if you look at say view requirements, you see the requirement gets created. Okay, so this way you're going to get it, all requirements in Quality Manager, just one by one. What are the requirements you have, right? You just bring all these requirements into Quality Manager. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like how many requirements you have, right? Just do copy paste everything into a Quality Manager. So so clear on these requirements. What the links approvals history? Basically the approvals and the history is who is going to approve this particular requirement. So here you will get, if you have any kind of document you want to link, so you can always browse and then attach those documents, any kind of files you want to attach. Like you want to attach the requirements documents or you want to attach any other files, you can always link them, link to this requirement. The approvals is who approved this particular document. Right, so you can select who is going to review these requirements and then who approved. You can identify the person's names. Say once the business analyst create these requirements, somebody has to review those requirements, right? So you can select the reviewer's names and then who is going to review it. You can select the person name and then due date when this particular review is due. Can select all the dates and everything. History is basically tells you who reviewed these documents and what are the changes done to this particular requirement. That is mainly the history tab. Okay. Yeah, requirement ID generated automatically. So mostly like in real time, who is going to use this requirements module? In fact, that's mainly the business analyst responsibility. So business analyst has to create all these requirements. But you know, the fact is everybody is under impression like all these quality manager and quality center tools, those are the testing tools. Then the business analyst is simply reluctant to use these tools. What he says is, hey, I already created this requirements document. Why don't you guys just bring all these requirements into your quality center or quality manager tools, right? That's where like he end up with, no, I don't have time again to prepare all these requirements in quality manager. You just do copy paste these things, okay? So that part will be done by the tester. All right. Yes, basically like this quality manager is going to have the security assigned to a particular project. That means once you join a project, the project manager is going to create the username and password, and then your username will be attached to a particular project. So you cannot access any other projects. Okay, review requirements. Review of the requirements will be done by the senior person in the project, like say something like business analyst and his boss. So they're going to review the requirements, like the project manager and the business analyst. So once the business analyst creates the requirements, the project manager and the development team is going to review those requirements, right? So is that requirement feasible or anything that we need to change? Okay, so once that is done, the project manager and the development guys, even the testers also part of that discussion. Everybody will review those requirements and see what's the feasibility of that requirements. Is that requirements we can develop and test it. Then ultimately, once everybody come to a conclusion, yes, we are going to do that, and either product manager or the business analyst is going to approve that. Okay. Or sometimes like it goes to the director or VP kind of role. They are going to approve those requirements. Okay. Tags is like keyword search. Okay, so once you create a tag, so you can search, use the tag. All you have to put is here login, right? So once you search, say for example, so here I want to search for the any kind of login requirements. You put the login and then click on this search, search is going to bring the login requirement. Okay, so these are the keywords it's going to bring using that tag. Okay, Dharani, please stay on. We're just discussing the requirements. We have not yet done any test cases. So you're going to paste the requirements here in the description. This is where you just copy from the old document and paste it here. That's the requirement description. Okay. Requisite Pro is a separate tool. Okay. Requisite, sometimes what the companies will do is, we are not going to buy any quality manager because quality manager tool is a little bit expensive. What they do is instead of buying the quality manager itself, they buy individual tools. Like, okay, we just need a requisite pro where we manage only just the requirements. Right? And the later part of the time, you created all the requirements, but later we decided we are going to buy quality manager also. By the time you already created the requirements in Requisite Pro, right? So you can directly import them. Okay. Hi, guys. Are there any questions? I think I believe I answered most of your questions. Still any more questions? So the next part is I'm going to do this test planning, and then we'll do the break, then I can look at your fault manager issues on your system. Okay, probably like I'm going to take control of one system, and then I can explain so that rest of the people can do the same thing. Okay. And then once you gather the requirements, this way actually you're going to create all the all requirements in the project. And the next thing is the planning. So this way you're going to prepare the project test plan. So again, you're going to create a test plan, or you can view the existing test plan, or you can import the test plan also from Word documents and so on. So when you're creating the test plan, this job is mostly done by the project manager, but you should know how it will be done in quality management. Sometimes, if you are a senior person in the project, maybe you'll be asked to create the test plan. In either case, like it's better to know, have the knowledge how the test plan will be created in the quality manager. So here you're going to prepare. You're going to give the title of the document. Give me one sec. Okay. So you can mention the test plan, the title, whatever the project name, right? So I'm going to say, so T-Mobile project test plan. And then, so you see, these are basically different sections in the test plan. And then, so I'm going to talk about the summary. So the description. So let me open the document, the sample test plan, how it looks like in Word document. That then you will get some So this is the kind of test plan we prepare, like it's a Word document. The same thing that you can also prepare in quality management. So basically we're going to talk about the summary, right? What is the project? And then these are basically the objectives, like what we are preparing this test plan. So here he's going to put the summary, the description of the project. So this is online bill payment and processing system. Something like about the model at a high level what this project is. So I go to the business objectives and why we are preparing this test plan. For all the business objectives, right? So communicate to all responsible parties, like basically like why we prepare the test plan. So you should have a transparent what you're going to do on this project, right? Test planning. You're going to planning different activities, what you do on this particular project. That is the test plan. That means you're going to identify what are the tests that you're going to do, what are the requirements you're going to test, and what are the machines that you need, what's the hardware, software, and the team, who is doing what, the responsibilities, what are the deliverables. That is where you're going to identify all the things in the test run. These are the different sections, like what are the entry criteria, exit criteria, right? And what are the test environments, the machines that you need, the test team, what is the team working on this particular project, and what are their responsibilities, who is doing what. So that's where, once you prepare this test plan, then it will be communicated to the senior manager or the director. These are like the first manager is going to prepare the test plan, and then he communicate to the senior manager. So that senior manager will look at this test plan, and then he's going to approve this. Okay, once we got the approval, then we are going to work on the project. And then we follow the test plan, and then test the project as per this test plan, what is defined. So that's where he is going to just say, communicate to all responsible parties. Sometimes you are going to communicate the same thing even to the customer also. Customer also has to approve the test plan documents. About so communicate to the responsible parties about the testing activity. So this way, it's going to come up with the business objectives, and the test objectives is like what are the different kinds of testing, like why. So testing team. To do the system testing to achieve the desired quality of the system. Right, so these are basically like a high level. The business objectives is mainly to communicate to the responsible party about the testing activities. And the testing objectives is mainly we are going to do the system testing to achieve the desired quality of the application of the system. And then once the project manager prepares this test plan, he is going to identify who is going to review this particular test plan. So go to the formal review section, and then he is going to look at who is going to review this particular document. So here he is going to create an item, and then who is going to review it. So we're going to identify the person. Okay, so reviewer, and then so going to identify locate, and then he's going to review this particular document. The reviewer. And then he also identify who is going to approve this particular document. Most like these are basically the senior managers, director kind of people. They're going to select from this list. Okay. So who is the reviewer, and then who is going to approve this particular document. So they are basically called the peer reviews kind of thing. Okay, so reviewer and approver. And then next thing is you're going to mention here the requirements. So you're going to identify here what are all the requirements we are going to work in this project. See, whenever you do, say, for example, you get some 9 requirements on the project, right? Say login, or say bill pay, credit card, or bill pay, debit card. You get different requirements on the project. That's where you gather all the requirements in the requirements module. But what happens is when you do the test plan, you're going to identify what is the in scope and out scope. So what's the difference between the in scope and out scope? What's the difference between the in scope and out scope? Anybody? Sorry, here I'm going to look at. So what's the in scope and out scope? Scope means limitation. Requirements covered in this release. Good. So in scope is requirements covered in this release is in scope. Very good. So that's where, along with the development team, he's going to discuss. And then what are the requirements that are possible in this particular release, in the current release? Then they're going to say, okay, login and bill pay credit card, we are going to develop. Because the business only says we have 6 months time. Is it possible to develop all these 9 requirements in 6 months time? Then we're going to look at, okay, what are all the things that comes in scope? Within this 6 months time, can we work on all these requirements? Or only limited requirements. That's where they're going to bring, okay, we are going to work on just login and bill pay in these 6 months. Then later, the next 6 months, probably we are going to work on debit card requirements. That means in the current release, that goes as out of scope. So that's where mainly he's going to focus here. He's going to add in this current release test plan, what are the requirements we are going to test? So go to the requirements column, requirements section, and identify what are the requirements that we develop, what are these requirements. So click on this add button, and then we are going to select, hey, because here you will get the list of all requirements in the project. Then he is going to look at, okay, these are all the requirements we are going to do in this test plan, in this current release. He identified from this list, and then click on this. So that these are the requirements is part of this test plan. The rest of the requirements go out of the scope. Maybe that will be done in the next release. So that time we are going to come up with a new test plan. Okay. And then the risk assessment will be done again. In the project, like you will get the risk, right? What are the risks? What is a risk? And each risk should have a mitigation plan. Okay? So what is the risk involved in the project? What are the different risks involved in the project? First of all, what's the risk? Can you tell me? Because, listen guys, on the test plan, you will get definitely 3 or 4 questions as a tester. You should answer this kind of question. What is the risk in the project? Delay in release. Changes in the requirements. Okay, changes in the requirements is a risk. Okay, I agree. What's the mitigation plan for that? What's the mitigation plan for the risk? Say, for example, the risk is technical risk. So the people who are working on the project, we are talking about telecom application like T-Mobile. So you don't have much knowledge about the telecom application, right? How it works. So, that's a risk. You don't know the telecom system, how it works, the domain. then what's the mitigation plan for that? How to overcome that risk? What's the mitigation plan? How to overcome that risk? You don't know about the domain. You don't know training, right? Good. So you ask for the training. Okay, hey, can you please give me training on how the telecom system works so that I can do the testing? So that's where the product manager is going to come up with all the risk. All the risk, and then he's going to come up with the mitigation action for that. So here, say for example, insufficient test resources. That means you don't have sufficient number of people to work on this project. Then what's the mitigation plan? Start recruiting, get new people on board. Insufficient test configurations. Test configurations is nothing but you don't have configuration is nothing but different operating system and the browser combinations, right? What you're going to test, right? Say Windows 7, Windows 8, Windows XP, these are all the different operating systems, and also the browsers, Firefox, Chrome. Insufficient test configurations. Then the mitigation plan is get new hardware as early as possible in the project. So this way, you're going to come up with what are the risks involved in the project, and then how to overcome that risk, the mitigation plan. And then she's going to come up with the next thing is the test schedules. So when are we going to do different testing activities and what are the due dates? Right, she's going to add all the testing activities. So something, the system testing, and when we do this system testing. Planned start date and planned end date. Or automation testing, regression testing. So we're going to come up with different testing activities or user acceptance testing. So what's the plan duration? Depends on what's your start and end date. It's come up with the number of days planned for types of testing. Okay, and then whenever you, because these are the planned activities, right? You are thinking to start doing this system testing on this date. But actual start date, did you actually start on 18th or was it delayed? Okay, and the actual end date, when it was done. So the actual duration it took is 10 days. That means actually you planned for 13 days, but actually you did in 10 days. That means you overestimated, right? That way now you can always keep track all this, the schedules. The project manager is going to look at, oh, okay, we thought of doing, we're taking this 13 days, but it took just 10 days. That means we overestimated. These are basically the lessons learned. That way in the next project, the project manager definitely look at, okay, it may not take that much time to do the system testing, right? So these are the planned efforts and actual efforts. So those comes under the test schedules and the test estimations. So here, the test estimations are mainly looking at what are the number of man hours required to prepare the test cases, and what are the man hours required to prepare to execute the test case, or what are the man hours required to prepare to develop any automation test suites. So here we're going to come up with the quantity, number of test cases versus the man hours. And the test environments, mainly you're going to identify what are the environments you're going to test. If it is a web application, you're going to look at so what are the environments, what are the browsers you're going to test, And then, so here you're going to look at the test environment. Create button. So here it gives what are all the different operating systems you are going to test, and then I don't know why it's not allowing me to do this. Okay. So here comes. So you're going to click on this button in order to get, see, you're going to look at what are the browsers you're going to test on this. Say Firefox, Internet Explorer, Safari, Chrome. You're going to identify all those environments and also the versions, what you test, the environment. Right? Similarly, you're going to identify all the operating systems. On which operating systems, on which browsers you're going to test this application. Okay, so here the test environment comes where you're going to add all the operating systems. So browsers and operating systems. So here it gives all its operating systems, like including the Unix, Windows, and all those operating systems. So you're going to look at what are the different operating systems you're going to test this particular application. Say Windows NT, Windows 2003, and Windows XP, and all those things. You're going to identify, okay, these are the operating systems you're going to test this particular application. It both comes under the test environments. And the next one is in this, we're going to look at the test team, who is working on this particular project and what their responsibilities. So click on this manage teams, and you're going to add all those the team members, like say the roles. And also you're going to, that's what somebody is asking, how you're going to do this access control. So basically you're going to give this access control depends on the roles. Who is basically like the administrator on this team? So this is the person like administrator. And then who are all the team members? Administrator is nothing but your manager or the team lead. And the members comes here, the team members. Right, so you can add, so you can look at what are all the teams, the team members, so that that particular person added the team member. Whereas, whoever is the administrator, he can have full control on the project. Administrator can create a user, whether it's a member, don't create any user. Or you cannot assign any particular user. Administrators can assign. It can create a user and you can assign the user to the project. So this way you're going to identify who are the administrators on the project and who are the team members. Okay, is it clear, like who asked this question? Can we give access control to the project? The configuration and everything will be done by the administrator. So you need not involve much on this administrator stuff. Whoever is identified as administrator, right, he will take control of the configuration. Okay, so that way you're going to identify all the team members who is working on the on this particular project. And then the quality object is basically you're going here, you're going to come up with what are the different types of testing we do, which in Alimbeth you can define the test strategy, like what are the different types of testing, system integration, regression, create all those different items here. And then you're going to look at what are the different types of testing, which is nothing but the system test strategy. That comes under here. And the next section is the entry and exit criteria. This is a very important thing, where you're going to look at what is required for you to start testing, the entry and exit criteria. Entry criteria is what is required for you to start testing. What comes under the entry criteria? What is entry criteria? What is required for you to start testing? This is a very important question. What is the difference between entry and exit criteria? So entry criteria is, yes. So yeah, very good. Here some people are saying the requirements, the tools, test environment, test cases is not the entry criteria. Test cases are the one you're going to work on. You're going to write the test cases part of your project. That's not the entry criteria. Requirements, software, hardware, and those stuff, right? The requirement comes under the entry criteria. So requirements and mainly the project resources to start working on the project, right? So hardware, the machines, and software. And the team. Then what is entry criteria? What comes under the entry criteria? That means when you are going to exit the project, when you stop testing. Exit criteria. Yes, so all, we cannot say all defects are closed, right? So most of the time, like we're going to say, okay, 90% of the defects are fixed. Or what are the things that influence the exit criteria? All requirements met. These are very important things. Whether you use quality center or quality managers, these are the questions that we asked in the interviews. Okay, what you mentioned in the test plan in exit criteria, all in entry criteria, all requirements missed, or you can say 95% of the test cases passed. 95% test cases passed. Okay, schedules reached. That means we had to release the software. Schedules are raised. Something like the budget is depleted. We don't have enough budget on this project. So they are the factors that influence the exit criteria, right? And you're going to stop testing. So that's where you're going to mention here the entry and exit criteria. Okay, entry criteria. And you're going to define what is the entry criteria and also the exit criteria. So here, this is what the exit criteria, right? It says the number of defects, number of failed execution, the test cases. So you're going to look at, this is basically the percentage, right? So pass rate, that means number of test cases passed. It should be greater than 80%, then we are good, right? Number of defects, or number of, what is this severe one, right? That means the major defects, the severity one defects. Like you have the defects that have severity levels high and low, right? If the severity is low, that is okay. But if severity is high, those defects should be fixed before we release the software. So that's where the severity defects must be closed. Severity two defects, like high, low, and medium, right? So medium defects should be less than 10%. Something like you're going to come up with this kind of exit criteria in the project. So you're going to identify, okay, this should be part of my exit criteria. Or I want the number of test cases should be, the pass test cases should be more than 80%. Okay, so this way you can identify what are the things that you want to set as a exit criteria. This other question, like in the interviews, right? So as a tester, this is a very frequent question. As a tester, how you ensure the software meets the quality? As a tester, how you ensure the software meets the quality? So how you answer this question? Yes, by looking at exit criteria. Good. So you're going to refer the exit criteria and the test plan. Because that's what the exit criteria says, right? So what are the exit criteria that mentioned here? If it meets, your software meets this criteria, then you're good. Your software meets the quality. And then you're ready to release. Similarly, before, like I forgot to ask this, the scope and strategy. What is the difference between the scope and strategy from the test plan? What's the difference between the scope and the strategy? Strategy is the approach. Scope is basically what to test. That means what requirements we are going to test, the scope. And strategy is how to test. That means what types of testing we do. This is the difference between this. To difference between the scope and strategy. Next, we can ask question like so far what we had discussion on the test plan. So you will get this kind of question. How do you know your project responsibilities? How do you know your project responsibilities? How you know your project responsibilities? So by looking at the test plan, right? The test plan will say, so here, so you have a test plan, right? That's where like you have a test team. That's where you're going to define what are the team members and then what are their responsibilities. Who is doing what? So you refer the test plan. Okay, so those are the frequent last questions from the test plan. And also, we're going to look at the test cases, but here, anyway, like we haven't done any test cases. But once you're done with the test cases in the construction module, then you can also mention those test cases in the test plan. Okay? So anyway, this part, we're going to come back and look at once you're done with the test cases. And the resources. Basically, the resources are mainly like what kind of the tools that you need, right? The testing tools. So you're going to identify all those the test resources. Like you need any functional testing tools, like manual testing, or you're going to do any performance testing. Service testing is mainly to test any web services. You've got to locate all those things. And also you're going to look at any attachments here. Attachments are mainly any kind of requirements, documents, or anything you can link to the test plan in the attachments module. So this way, actually, like the project manager responsibility, he's going to go through all these different sections, and then he prepares this test plan. But as a tester, you should know what are these different sections and the content. Okay, so you guys have any questions? Resources are mainly like what kind of testing you're doing, right? Say performance testing, you have sufficient resources, like what kind of machines you need to do the performance testing, and that kind of stuff. The project manager will do those resources. Identify all the test configurations. So do you have enough tools, and then what kind of machines you need to do the different types of testing. Here is going to look at so there are the different tools. Okay, so script type, and then from where you're going to execute this, how you're going to look at the different types of testing, functional testing, performance testing, and service testing. Service testing is mainly to test any services, web services, that kind of stuff. Manual testing, these are basically robot and functional testers, the automation testing tools. And the test case is mainly, like because you're going to build some test cases, and then come back and link those, like whenever you link the requirement, you're going to identify what are the test cases you're going to do. Right now, actually, you don't have any test cases. That way, it's not showing anything here. Once you build the test cases here from the construction module, so you're going to add all the test cases back to the test plan. Okay, you tell me. Sirisha, as a tester, what is your role in preparing the test plan? You people have undergone this clear session. What is your role in preparing the test plan? okay, attending project kickoff meetings. Right, you're going to attend the project kickoff meeting as a test, as a tester, and then you're going to involve in the discussion with the project manager and your team members. And then the next thing is the project manager is going to prepare the test plan. So your participation, your contribution is attending the project kickoff meetings. Okay. Is that clear? That's what you do in that meeting. You're going to discuss with the team members and then see what you need and then how you're going to test it. What kind of machines you need, what kind of tools you need, that kind of things that you're going to discuss with your team members. You're not involved in the test cases. That is your responsibility. You're going to write the test cases. Right? That is where actually you are hired on the project. That is your main responsibility. I don't know. Depends on like whether if you say, okay, I prepare the test plan, then you are ready to answer the questions, how you did that. If you're able to answer that, then you're good. Estimation will be done by the project manager based on his past experience. Okay, any other questions on the test plan? Is this clear? What is test plan? Who prepares that? As a tester, did you ever prepare the test plan? Say yes or no. As a tester, did you ever prepare the test plan? Yes or no? No. Okay. Okay, all right, guys. I'm getting mostly no. That is PM's job, but don't say that is PM's job. Okay, that you say, I didn't get a chance to prepare the test plan. Then whose responsibility is? That the interviewer will take care of it. The interviewer will take care of whose responsibility is, then he will understand that. You say, I didn't get a chance to prepare the test plan. That means given a chance, you can do that. Okay, that's why you are learning these things here. Then, what is your involvement and contribution in preparing the test plan? So you say you didn't prepare the test plan. Then, what is your involvement? Project kickoff. Okay, you attend project kickoff meetings and then discuss with your team members and your project manager and give your inputs in the same meeting. Okay, so that's about the test plan. And the next module here is the construction. That's where you're going to prepare the test cases. Okay. So, are you guys okay? Can I continue one more hour? You guys are overloaded? Okay. Because I don't know, I'm getting too many questions, that's why I'm not doing as per the time, as per the schedule. Because I think at least like we need at least 2 hours, because I need to cover this construction. That's where that's the main thing, how you're going to write the test cases and the execution of test case and then create the defects. These are the three main modules. Okay. Okay, probably then we will do next week. Can you please take rest in next class? Yeah, we will do next week on weekdays. Okay. I guess that's all from my side then today. Do you guys have any questions? Can one of you guys share your system so that I can, who is not able to open? Okay, anybody can share. One sec, I think I have to give the permissions. Can you share your system? Just click on that show me screen button. Okay. Okay, just can you go to your startup menu? Okay. No, go to your startup menu on the left side. Yeah. Yeah, click on that. The left next button. Yeah, click on that. Okay, all programs. And then scroll down where you see this scroll down here, click on that. Okay, other people just get to watch this, what we are doing. You have to go to this IBM National, the next one. No, not that one. You see next folder, IBM National, down, yeah, double click on that. Click on that. Okay, now you start IBM, no, the next one. Next one. Yeah, select that one. Start IBM apps contest edition. Okay, let's say you minimize this one. Then go to startup menu again. And then now you set up, go to setup. Yeah, select that one. And then enter the same URL, like HTTPS, what you see there. You enter the same thing. Yeah, enter that, like HTTPS. Can you type? Not here, on the same window. Type here, HTTPS, whatever that you see. Okay, hit enter key. Type admin, the username. Okay, hit enter key. Password is also admin. Yeah, hit enter key. Okay. So now you go to startup menu again. Then you go to now, about that there is a start IBM National. No, go stop. Go a little bit up. Yes. No, yes, select that one. Can you minimize these windows? Okay, now you refresh this page. Click on refresh. Yeah, probably like you don't have this you are not the administrator, that's what he's saying. If you open those windows again. He's saying the access is denied. Probably you have to open this as administrator. Okay, close these windows. Close it. Close all these windows. And then you have to right click and start as administrator. Okay, go to startup and then do the process. Now first come down. Yeah, right click. You have to right click on that. What? Did you right click on that? Close this window. Go to Startup menu again. What is the plus symbol you see? No, don't select that one. What is that plus symbol? Click on that. Okay, now you right click on that start here. You see, you'll get a window. What is this operating system? Windows 8. Okay, so probably like you can you select the phone? I really can't say this Windows 8, this GUI part. Can you move this window, please? This local host, or you can close this page. Close that page. Okay, can you go to your desktop? Just minimize these things. This is also not required. Go to your desktop. And where? Okay, where is this one? Go to your startup menu. You have the desktop, right? Where you see all these icons. Look at this. Okay, yeah, this one. Can you scroll right? Okay, you can search here IBM. Okay, so now you right click on this start IBM, third item from the bottom. Right click and then Sun as administrator. Did you get any pop-up window? You say yes, if you get any pop-up window. The system cannot find the JAWS not exist. Did you install this? Did you get any installation issues? Okay, seems like then it's not, the installation is not done properly. It's saying they cannot find the JAWS.txt. Okay, anyway, like, can you minimize this one and then go and start the next one? Go to the desktop again. Then search for IBM. And then you start now this setup. Can you click on on this setup and then right click.